Hello friends, welcome to part 3 of High Performance Computer Architecture Pipelining Hazard. Pipelining hazard is a situation which prevents next instruction in the instruction set from executing during its designated clock cycle. They are due to dependencies present among the instructions. Now what is dependency? Dependency is the property of instructions in a program which can cause a hazard. There are three kinds of dependency: structural dependency, data dependency, and control dependency. Data dependency is further classified into true data dependency and false data dependency, also known as name data dependency. Read after write dependency or a flow dependency is example of true data dependency, and write after read dependency or anti dependency, and write after write dependency or output dependency are example of false data dependency. Now first hazard is structural hazard. It is due to structural dependency or resource conflict in the pipeline. It's a situation in which more than one instruction tries to access the same resource in the same clock cycle. In this time diagram, we can see there is resource conflict between instruction fetch stage of fourth instruction and memory access stage of first instruction, because both stages need access to memory. So what are the solutions to structural hazard? In order to prevent resource conflict between instruction fetch and memory access stage, the memory is divided into two independent modules, instruction memory and data memory. Other general solution is bringing stalls. A stall is a delay in execution of an instruction in order to resolve a hazard. In this normal execution of instruction in a pipeline, there is a hazard in between instruction 4 and first instruction. So we put a stall in the fourth clock cycle and start our instruction fetch in the fifth clock cycle. Again we have a resource conflict with memory access stage in the second instruction. So here also we put a stall and start our instruction fetch in the sixth clock cycle. Again we have a resource conflict with memory access stage in third instruction. So here also we put a stall and start our instruction fetch in the seventh clock cycle. Now we have three stall cycles, and total number of clock cycles to execute these instructions are 11. Next is data hazard. Data hazards occur due to data dependency across instruction which passes through the pipeline. There are three types of data hazard: read after write hazard, write after write hazard, and write after read hazard. The first one is read after write hazard. It occurs when second instruction tries to read data before first instruction writes it. For example, suppose we have two instructions, add R1, R2, R3 and subtract R4, R1, R5. In the first instruction, the value is to be written on R1, and in the second instruction, the value is to be read from R1. So this hazard happens when second instruction tries to read the data before first instruction writes it. Let's illustrate this hazard with the help of an example. Suppose we have following instruction set. We see in all the instructions from I2 to I5, there is read after write dependency for R1. Now the updated value of R1 will be available only after write back stage of instruction 1. But instruction I2, I3 and I4 fetch the value of R1 in their ID stage, that is before write back stage of first instruction. Hence all instructions I2, I3 and I4 get unupdated or wrong value of R1. So there is a hazard. In the fifth instruction, its ID stage takes place after write back stage of instruction 1, so no hazard will be there. Next is write after read hazard. It happens when second instruction tries to write the data before first instruction reads it. Here I1 is reading R2 and instruction 2, I2, is writing on R2. For an in-order execution, that is when execution takes place sequentially, this hazard never happens, because in sequential execution, R2 will be read first, then only R2 is written. But this hazard can take place when execution occurs out of order, that is when instructions are executed non-sequentially. Next is write after write hazard. It happens when second instruction tries to write the data before first instruction writes it. Here also, for in order execution, this hazard is never going to be happen. But when instructions are executed out of order, this hazard can take place. Read after write dependency is true data dependency, because here reader needs the result of writer. It can be solved by linking stocks and operand forwarding. Write after write and write after read are false data dependency, or they are also called name data dependency, because they exist due to limited number of register or memory names. Hence, they can be solved by register renaming. Now, first solution to data hazard is introducing stalls. Suppose we are following instruction set. Now, the hazard here is because of R1 value in instruction I2, I3 and I4 is unupdated value. So to remove this hazard, we shift the ID stage after write back stage of instruction 1. Hence, there will be 3 stall cycles and total number of clock cycles will be 12. Next solution is operand forwarding. In operand forwarding, we forward the updated data of R1 from previous pipeline stage to the current pipeline. Since data in each stage is stored in the intermediate latch, we can forward the updated data from there. So we forward the updated value of R1 from EX or MEM latch of instruction 1 to the ALU of second instruction. Again, we forward the updated value of R1 from MEM or write back latch of instruction 1 to the ALU of instruction 3. And again, we forward the updated value of R1 from register file of instruction 1 to the register file of instruction 4. The advantage of data forwarding is that here number of stalls will be less. Hence, total number of clock cycles here will be 9. Next is register renaming. Register renaming is a solution to false or name data dependency, that is WAW and WAR hazards. Since name data dependency is due to limited number of register or memory names, they can be solved by register renaming. Register renaming is changing name of register, causing the hazard. In this example, there is write after read hazard. By renaming the register R2 in the second instruction, we can remove this hazard. That's all for this video. We will continue our discussion in the next video. Thank you.